This conference will now be recorded.
Welcome to Dr. TSPR show. Neen me Dr. Tangella Shiva Prasad Reddy alias Dr. TSPR. Namaste, adab, hello. World Nature Conservation Day. Greetings to one and all. Prapancha Pariyavarana Parirakshana Dinotsavam ee roju aa sandarbhanga యావత్ ప్రజానికానికి శుభాకాంక్షలు తెలుపుతూ అసలు ఈ పరిరక్షణ దేని గురించి జరుపుకుంటా ఉన్నాం, వై ఆర్ వి సెలబ్రేటింగ్ దిస్ వరల్డ్ నేచర్ కన్జర్వేషన్ డే, ది ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్ ఇన్ ది కంటెంపరీ అండ్ కంటెంపరీ హ్యాపెనింగ్స్ వెన్ వి రిలేటెడ్ టు ది ఫ్యూచర్, డిడ్ వి లెర్న్ ఎనీథింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ ది పాస్ట్. టు ఎక్స్ప్లోర్ దిస్ మనకు అతిథులు నన్ అదర్ దాన్ బివి సుబ్బారావు గారు, ఈజ్ ఎక్స్పర్ట్ ఎన్విరాన్మెంట్ అండ్ లేక్ ప్రొటెక్షన్ కమిటీ. ఇవి చాలా చిన్నవి, అవి రెండు ఎన్విరాన్మెంట్ లేక్ అనే వారిని అక్కడ కుదించకుండా నేచర్ వరల్డ్ ఎట్లయితే మనం మాట్లాడుకుంటున్నామో వరల్డ్ నేచర్ కన్జర్వేషన్, హీ యాప్ట్లీ ఫిట్స్ ఇన్ టు దాట్. వారు వెల్కమ్ టు ది స్పెషల్ షో సార్. అట్లే వారు మా గురుతుల్యులు, అట్లే మా గురువు గారు కూడా ప్రొఫెసర్ పురుషోత్తం రెడ్డి గారు కూడా జాయిన్ అవుతారు ఈ షోలో, లైవ్ షోలో. బివి సుబ్బారావు గారు ఒక ప్రత్యేకమైనటువంటి పరిస్థితుల్లో ఈరోజు వారు ఉన్నారు. వారు వారి తమ్ముణ్ణి కోల్పోయారు, హి లాస్ట్ ఈజ్ యంగర్ బ్రదర్. దే ఆర్ గోయింగ్ త్రూ సెరమోనియల్ ప్రొసీజర్స్ అంటే మనం అంటాం కదా, ఆ రోజులు వారు వారి తమ్ముని ఆత్మను శాంతించే ప్రయత్నంలో తమ్ముడు కుటుంబాన్ని అక్కున పెట్టుకొని వారిని ఓదార్చే ప్రయత్నంలో ఉన్న సమయంలో ఈరోజు వారు లైవ్ షోకు రావడం, ఆ లైవ్ షో కూడా ప్రత్యేక పరిస్థితి సంతరించుకున్నది కాబట్టి నేను వస్తున్నాను శివప్రసాద్, గో హెడ్ అండ్ ప్రిపేర్ ది పోస్టర్. పీపుల్ ఆర్ కన్ఫ్యూజ్డ్, ఏదో మొక్కలు నాటితే కాదు, అసలు ఏమిటి, ప్రజలకు అర్థమవుతుందా, ఇవే మాటలు వారు ఉదయం చెప్పారు. అందుగురించి వారికి మరొకసారి ఆహ్వానిస్తూ మే ఇస్ బ్రదర్ సోల్ రెస్ట్ ఇన్ పీస్, హర్ట్ ఫెల్ట్ సింపతీస్ టు ది ఫ్యామిలీ. సార్
నమస్కారం. వన్స్ అగైన్ థ్యాంక్స్ డాక్టర్ శివప్రసాద్
సార్.
టుడే ఈజ్ వరల్డ్ నేచర్ డే, కన్జర్వేషన్ డే. ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్లీ ఇట్ ఆల్ బిగిన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ June 5th, World Environment Day. Environment, it involves both the nature as well as the man-made environment. It all starts with that, and June 6th happens to be World Plantation Day. So it has a big cycle. You know, there are many days, important days were identified by the United Nations. It's only to remind the people time and again that you are part of this entire nature. You are not a separate entity by yourself. It only helps us to remind oneself. And the kind of resources we are losing day by day on the earth. The five essential resources, natural resources, land, water, air, energy, and space, is vanishing day by day. More than 50% of the population in the world are deprived of access to protected drinking water and environmentally safe sanitation. And forests are shrinking day by day. Last 2.5 decades, there is tremendous pressure on forests. And everybody wants a piece of land, and nobody cares. You know? Conservation has become everybody's business. No, it has become everybody's business to make money on the name of conservation. So we need to think what exactly mean by conservation. Today, after almost 1.5 months, we are talking on importance of. Let us look into this. Why the conservation? and what is the purpose of conservation, and how do we mainstream this conservation into the development plan. Unfortunately, even today, people talk in isolation. Environment is different from development. Let us first develop and then save the nature. You may develop a building in 1 month or 2 months' time. To develop a half hectare of forest takes years. And in 1 inch of productive fertile soil, some millions of years. So it's not in your hands, my dear. So think of nature. How do we integrate, learn how to coexist with the nature? That is most important. Today, this year, 2020 and 21 has witnessed devastating, you know, disasters all over the world. The country like Germany, which has the best forecasting technology, failed. It is challenging. The changing climatic situations are challenging our both traditional as our modern technologies. So we need to review once again. We need to check, recheck, you know, how do we build a compatible technology for efficient forecast mechanisms, and also to have an efficient planning of the human habitation, so that the human habitation will become a disaster resilient centers. So these are several challenges before us, and a country like India still suffers from traditional conservative political systems, and it doesn't grow beyond that. Unfortunately, it is not addressing the basic issue of coexistence. So we need to look into it and see why this conservation and what is the theme for this year. So it is a continuation of June 5th environment. It is not that suddenly something came up on conservation. So it is only reminding. United Nations is helping us in setting up this calendar to remind us these different, you know, concepts, approaches, strategies to build principles and practices of coexistence with nature. I request my friend, I have a small brief PowerPoint presentation. Yes, and it doesn't speak much on the science and technology or any other, but to inspire my participants on this issue.
Sir, you are the part. You are the presenter, sir. Yes, sir. You are the presenter now.
Thank you. Then I'm okay. Okay. Hope you people can see the presentation.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you see, the sustainable nature conservation. You see, what we are doing today is on the name of plantation. We
can make it full screen, sir.
Going in grace.
So make it full screen. Make it full screen, sir. You can.
Okay.
Before, I think it was better before. The earlier one was the best one.
Okay, sir.
Now this is better, sir.
Okay. So the most important thing is, how do we build and why should we conserve? Why the United Nations is so worried about our for conservation. So, and conservation is not merely some kind of a festival or an event where bureaucrats and the policy makers come and declare that we have planted 2 crore plant saplings this year, but why we should do it, what we should do it. These are all, challenges before us, and what is the sustainable way of nature conservation. why? Purpose of conservation. You see, there is a lot of resistance these days in India against the conservation. People do not want conservation zones. In honor and conservation, the green zones in the urban planning has become a joke. You know, when they prepare the master plan, they prepare everything. And within 6 months of the time, because of the pressure from, you know, different vested groups, the green zone becomes gray and then red. They can make anything anywhere. Is it possible? Do we have specific zones for conservation? Did we identify the conservation zones? Did we prioritize the conservation zones in the country that which are the highly sensitive conservation zones, which needs 24/7, 365 monitoring mechanisms? And we have not prioritized, we have not identified the conservation zones, we have not come out with the reasons for conservation, we have not educated people on conservation. Then how we can move it? All the fertile agriculture lands, productive lands, they are being converted for real estate all over the state and the country, and for the highways. Is it because, you know, even the environmental impact assessment has been diluted to to suit the corporate sector? Did we incorporate anything on education for conservation and sustainability in the school curriculum? At the faculty upgrading workshops? No. It is simply because, you know, my senior professor Purushottam Reddy garu always says it is important to transform the people into citizens. Once you become a citizen, you understand what is the constitution, what are your duties and responsibilities, and what are your rights. Right to live, right to work, right to life, and duties to protect the environment, duties to protect the water bodies. It is all there in the constitution. Are we following it? Similar way, when the conservation comes, it is humans versus human resources. We have not transformed the human into human resources. They do not have the pretty understanding of the true value of the natural resources. Today, the water has become a commercial commodity. Land has become commercial commodity. During the COVID period, even oxygen was sold in the black market. Is it not shame on your part? So people, the human resources, the world, was largely exploited by the corporate sector to make robots to work for them from 8 to 6. Nothing else. Whatever the human resources training programs we have, it is a tailor-made thing to suit the system. So we have not promoted the true spirit of human resources. And once the human resources, you teach them, sensitize them, build awareness, then comes the judicious use of natural resources. We are building a lot of, I congratulate the governments that, a lot of big irrigation reservoirs they are constructing. And at the same time, they are fighting. There is a conflict between the adjacent the states within the river basin on water distribution, but the states are not coming together on water river conservation, which is the source of water, and the catchments of the rivers, which is the real source of water, which feed these streams and the rivers. The governments are only interested to show off their ego on water distribution systems, but they have totally failed in making the farmers to shift to drip irrigation, judicious use of water in irrigation. Even today, be it a minor irrigation, medium irrigation, or a major irrigation, we follow the flood irrigation. Is it not a shameful act? doesn't it reflect the incapacity of our irrigation and water managers in the irrigation sector, that they have totally failed bringing a disciplined water use in the irrigation system? Then where is the conservation what we are talking about? Conservation is not merely, you know, one day come together, you know, talk on conservation and you say, I have conserved this and that, and then merrily have some party and go. It is not the conservation starts from your backyard to your community level, to your city. What is the conservation practices your city has? Does your city has a conservation policy? When it is changing its green to red zones, what is the use of it? Today, I know one of the you know, colonies at Bachupalli, you know, each house is costing around 1.5 to 2 crores, and that colony, two in one the family are suffering from the respiratory diseases. They have cleaned the bush forest there and created a human habitation, a real estate. The toxic gases that are released from the industrial area will directly hit this. But is anybody aware of it? The government gave all sanctions, government gives all kinds of sanctions. And today, we need to understand what is the purpose of a buffer zone between the lake and the housing, between the lake and the development, between the industry and the residential, between the industry and the commercial. There are the buffer zones. Buffer zones have been gone in the wind. And today, you do not have public spaces also. The farmers in the rural areas, they just throw all their paddy onto the road for drying the paddy. Is it the way we do it? Where are the public spaces? The trustees, the policy makers, they are selling the public spaces, the conservation zones, merrily. One of the conservation zones in Musi River catchment areas was merrily sold by the state government and some other authorities coming to set up an institution there. Did we gone into it? The environment impact assessment does not look into the, you see, the biodiversity, the invaluable biodiversity assessments. Recently, he's from Jetcherla, their students found you know, highly valuable medicinal plants in this zone. That means when the state made the agreement, they did not go into the environment impact assessment of that conservation zone. Conservation zones have to be studied and they have to be rated in terms of their sensitivity, in terms of their environment services. This is not happening in this country. You see, the whole problem is, you see, why conservation all? And this year, forest livelihood, sustaining people, planet, and livable planet. This is the last, this statement is from the, say, Abdul Kalam, when he was addressing in, I think, Guwahati University. This was, he said, we would like to see the livable planet. Is this a livable planet? What are you making of this? Let us look into some, you know, renowned environment. What are their perspective on? Conservation is a cause that has no end. So never say, I did so much and I want to take retirement. There is no retirement in conservation and environment movements. You have to work. It's a cause, it's a commitment till you breathe last. There is no point at which we will say our work is finished. How can you say that our work is finished? It's a dynamic system. Society changes, planet is changing. You know, the flora of fauna is changing. This is the statement from Rachel Carson, okay, who opened the eyes of American society, not only American society, but the entire world through her book, Silent Spring. And nature conservation is not morality or a charity. What we talk today under the CSR, the so-called CSR activities. Chalo, एक 10 पौधे लगा दो 1 करोड़ का बिल बना। दिस इज नॉट द यू नो कंजर्वेशन। कंजर्वेशन इज अ सीरियस बिजनेस, इट कॉल्स यूर डेडिकेशन एंड कमिटमेंट। दिस इज बट नेचर कंजर्वेशन इज नॉट मोरालिटी बट ए क्वेश्चन ऑफ सर्वाइवल। हू सर्वाइव? इट्स अवर सर्वाइवल। दिस इज फ्रॉम दलाई लामा। Nature has enough for everybody's need, but not for greed. This is from Mahatma Gandhi. Then where are we today? And our textbooks, our primary health, primary school and higher education, higher school books say a rich man has the opportunity to. So what kind of role models we are giving it? So we need to think on these aspects of it. These are the fundamental, you know, philosophies or concepts which drive the conversation. And you see, it the terms green movement or conservation movement are alternately used to denote the same. So as I said in the beginning, June 5th is the beginning of the calendar, and every international day only reminds different components of the environment movement. Today we are talking of nature. Tomorrow we may be talking of the ecosystems, and the other day maybe on industrial ecology, green industry, green infrastructure. But everything falls under the umbrella of environment. The environmental movement favors the sustainable movement. And these are the two things: why we conserve and why, what kind of a sustainable mechanism we ensure for conservation. These are things. And do we have protection of the environment by changes in public policy? We do not have a public policy. Then what kind of changes we make? Okay, so these are the issues we need to ponder, think, discuss. And you see, you look at when we talk of anything, I am also referring to the age old thing. Okay, conservation, the environment movement, everybody says it all started with Vishnoi movement. Yes, we are only looking Vishnoi movement as a movement against the system, no? A movement for conservation. This is the spirit of Vishnoi. So we need to understand, the Indian philosophy, but unfortunately we do not take any essence from this, but we always suffer, our political system suffer from, some kind of a or vote bank tricks. And after this we have the Chipko movement. Yes, Chipko movement aptly fits into, whether it is Chipko movement or Vishnoi movement of 400 years back. These are the movements which brings out, precipitates the human linkage on nature and livelihood. You see, they are not doing it for doing its sake. It is their livelihood. They know what to conserve, what to, get the gain out of this. Again, the Jungle Bachao Andolan, 1982, Singhbhum, Bihar. These are all the issues. They are not issues of, some rosy environmental movement. They are the issues of livelihoods. They are the issues of right to livelihood. They are the issues of right for conservation. They are conservationists. They are not any people who are against the system. Today, when we talk, environmentalist is against the government. Nobody is against the government. We are for the conservation. We want to mainstream the conservation. Interestingly, our Prime Minister has found that, the democracy in Chennai, somewhere in Chennai, he wants. But I thank my Dr. Shiv Prasad, my friend, for giving me this opportunity. And through this channel, I would like to reach out to many policy makers, including the Prime Minister. The modern conservation movement was first manifested in the forests of. Then where are we today? What are our stand? What is our stand? Where are our policies? Why we are diluting environment practices? Okay. The Madras Board of Revenue started local conservation efforts in 1842. headed by Alexander Gibson, a professional botanist. Okay, and then it was mainstream under the colonial rule, General Lord Dalhousie. Okay, then it went to United States, and say in 19th century, the conservation movement was very active in USA, and they could bring out very stringent policies, acts, and other things. Late 1950s and 60s, it is Rachel Carson who brought this, and the Sierra Club, which is again contributed a lot on the conservation movement. The Nature Conservancy is another international global organization, I say, which worked for that. So even the Greenpeace, which is mostly looked as a an activist group, always projects the pollution. Yes, we are losing our natural resources through pollution, through over depletion. So we need this. Then why we have to conserve? Okay. And today I thought people will talk on this. You see, why we have to conserve the forest? You know, in the protected areas and sanctuary areas, whether it is tiger or anything, it is only hardly 2.5 to 3% is the core area what they declare, where human intervention is supposed to be totally, controlled. You know why? Today, whatever we are enjoying on our dining table, the genetic seed came from this forest. The perennial pigeon pea, tomato, maize, everything came from. We are not allowing the process of evolution of this genetic bank. Why we should conserve? This is for our these are our genetic banks. Today, the so-called agricultural institutions siphoned out, hijacked all these seeds, and they are creating monopoly through the seed manufacturing. But we need to look into these genetic banks. We have all around Telangana and India the genetic banks. Please look into genetic banks. You see, every village, every panchayat is expected to bring out the register on the biodiversity. How many biodiversity out of the 12,000 and odd panchayats, how many biodiversity registers have been established in this state? This is my straight question to the state government. You see, these are the important things. Are we teaching this? And the domestic cats and the domestic dogs, they are all the original breeds which came from the forest areas. So we need to understand the invaluable resources of these genetic pools. And I wish that a policy should come out increasing the core areas of these zones in entire India, so that we can ensure the evolution of the genetic banks for the future generation. We do not know. Even the cancer, whatever, the entire pharma industry depends on these genetic banks. Then why the pharma industry is not supporting the conservation of the genetic banks? These core areas, this is most important. And I suggest to people to read the Al Gore book, Balancing the Earth. He very clearly came out with what kinds of plants and the seeds were exploited from the Amazon forest. Today, one of the beer manufacturer guy in UK makes billions of dollars because the seed he got from Amazon gives the taste to the beer. But are we educating? Is there any policy on education for conservation, education for sustainability? No. Every year, I think from, I was looking into the mangrove water. Just 2 days back, World Mangrove Conservation Day came. As I told you, June 5th is the starting day. Every month we have one issue or the other, one subject or mangroves, they protect the land from flooding of the sea water system. They control it. they also act as wind barriers of the cyclone winds, which come from any velocity of 50 to 100 kilometers per hour. And they are the plants, you know, which give a lot of, its bark is used in the tanneries, leather softening and other things. There are many other benefits, many other things. But our neighbor's state cleared 150 acres of the mangrove forest, and you know they want to start housing for poor people. What kind of a joke? The state which frequently suffers from cyclones does not recognize the value and services, environment services of these mangroves. Is a shame on our part, on governance, so-called governance. Springs, the natural springs, nobody bothers about. The catchment areas of the forest, nobody looks into it. These are the issues which we need to look into. Which kind of a forest, what type of a habitation helps in conserving it? What is its environment service? Urban lakes, yes. Today, urban lakes have become the centers of weather change and climate change because they are emitting methane gas. All the shit is dumped in the lakes. Are we looking into the services of these lakes? The lakes of Hyderabad, the fundamental, the natural function is regulating the floods. What is that? Why we should conserve, we should understand it. And conservation, we have not mainstreamed in the syllabus of planning, architecture and planning. And what we are teaching to these people, they become jokers of planning in the entire government system. And they do not care for these natural elements. It is time. I request the Prime Minister to look into it and revive, ask the concerned authorities and the education system to change the entire syllabus from KG to PG in all disciplines. It's important. Why the conservation? Purpose of conservation? How the planning has to be done? It's important. Niti Aayog is looking and only looking into the pitfalls of the state governments. Let the Niti Aayog also come out with the policies. That is the primary responsibility of Niti Aayog as a planning body. Okay, you may not relish when I say planning, but as a planning body, it has its own responsibilities. So we need to look into the environment services of all these. Okay, and then the grasslands in the central India, grasslands of the Rajasthan. Are we looking into all these things? No. Mainstreaming of conservation strategies is a big challenge in our state, country. At least, if they have implemented, they would have implemented 73, 74. At least we could sit with panchayats, presidents and sensitized, and they understand much better of these conservation strategies, the value of these conservation. What these people understand sitting in Hyderabad talking of Itu Nagaram, the cane growth, they don't have any idea. I'm sure. 80% of the state minister, they do not have any idea of the natural cane growth in Telangana. Sustainable conservation principles and practices. How do we evolve these principles and practices of conservation? How do we mainstream it? How do we integrate this in the planning and in the syllabus of architectural planning, regional planning, and also urban development institutions across the country. Urban development institutions are not real estate people who make plots, auction the land for the policy makers. They are the people who have to make a sustainable planning. They should have much better. And all the urban development in the planning department, we should have a multidisciplinary team. And the team leaders should have better understanding of migrants. Otherwise, the country will face more disasters in the coming period. Conservation policy do have a conservation policy. Implementation mechanism. Forget when you have, when you do not have. But even if you have the policy and certain things, we do not have effective implementation mechanisms. Where is the monitoring and evaluation? People's monitoring and evaluation. Are people participating in the planning, in preparing the master plan, and understanding the conservation plans? It's very important to look into all these things. Okay, there are several things which our universities had to open up their eyes. Design for environment, design for nature, eco-cities, industrial ecology, green infrastructure, green building, except thanks to Bill Clinton, who opened the green building in the Madhapur, we do not have anything. And the traditional housing is not assessed to what degree it is green, how much energy it conserves. We are only looking into new buildings, new real estate guys. There is a long way to go in understanding the conservation. And I once again thank the United Nations that, you know, it has kept a beautiful calendar reminding us throughout the year on different components of the environment. Today we are talking on conservation, and conservation is not merely planting it. Why tree? What is the purpose of that tree? Can it survive at that particular place where I am planting it? There are several reasons to discuss and understand. Can this tree attract, invite the birds? What kind of birds? There are many things. We are only interested in the number. I have today, this year we have planted, and I'm very sorry to say how the Niti Aayog is also endorsing the state government's, you know, so-called achievement on greening this tree. We need to look into it. We need a people's auditing on this, like social auditing, on the conservation audit, and identify the conservation. The so-called heritage, you know, societies and all, they're all, you know, goody-goody, looking into historical things, not looking into the nature conservation. It's time that my senior, Professor Purushottam Reddy, should think of, you know, motivating the youngsters on conservation clubs. And I thank my friend, Dr. Shiv Prasad. And we need to look into all this conservation, where we conserve. You see, conservation to adopt climate change, conservation for the life below the water, conservation for the life on earth. There are, we need partnerships. We need strong institutions for conservation. It is not a day old meeting where a minister comes, you know, bureaucrat comes, you know, everybody comes, have chai, samosa, and then some people do the plantation. This is not this. Okay. There are several things we have to think of. I thank once again my friend Dr. Shiv Prasad for giving me this opportunity. Conservation is not a merely a one-day activity, a one-man's life sentence. It's a continuous process from one generation to the other. We look, we seniors in this field look for exchange, pass on the baton to the younger generation on conservation. We are eager to, you know, share our experiences and knowledge with anyone who is interested for a balanced planet, a livable planet. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Yes, sir. If you come out of the presentation mode, then I have some 5 to 6 questions for you, so that people will understand.
Okay, sir. I'm just.
Yeah.
Okay, and then. Okay. How do you, this screen be?
Okay. 1 second, sir.
Oh, thank you. Thank
yeah,
you.
We are out of it.
Thank you.
The main questionnaire, 1 second, sir, I'll just remove this thing also because it's trying to just disturb. Yeah. The main purpose is, the first question is, these days it has become a fashion on the eve of their birthdays of politician or something, wherein OT Mokkalu archana. Now they are saying puja like archana. How symbolic, is it a symbolic way, or does it have any fruitful contribution to towards the conservation?
This is a plantation, you see, in spite of several serious attempts in promoting the awareness and sensitizing in our country, the moment we talk of environment, they only talk of plantation. And plantation, you know, it goes without any proper planning. That is proper. And you see, I still remember the road, the Adilabad road, Adilabad, Nizamabad road. We have a lot of marichat unnanta kalanga akkada em ayyadi banyans. So their fruit is attracts a lot of parakeets who are seed consumers, and they have removed all those trees, and these parakeets now they attack the jowar peas. So what you are planting, what purpose your plantation will go, and what is the end result what you are expecting? So unless and until you have such a systematic planning and monitoring and auditing mechanism, see, everything is not green. Everything that glitters is not gold.
Mere se alla bangaram kaadu ayya mantrullara cinema actorlara ఇప్పుడైనా అర్థం చేసుకోండి, ఒక శాప్లింగ్, ఒక మొక్క నాటే ముందు ఎందుకు నాటుతున్నారు, దేని గురించి నాటుతున్నారు, ఎక్కడ నాటుతున్నారు, నాటిన తర్వాత దాని పరిస్థితి ఏమిటి. యు హ్యావ్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ వై యు ఆర్ ప్లాంటింగ్ ఎ శాంప్లింగ్, వేర్ యు ఆర్ ప్లాంటింగ్, వాట్ ఈస్ ది పర్పస్ అండ్ హౌ టు మెయింటైన్, హౌ ఇట్ క్యాన్ ఎన్హాన్స్ కన్జర్వేషన్. దీస్ థింగ్స్ హ్యావ్ టు బి బోర్న్ ఇన్ మైండ్. జస్ట్ ఫర్ ది సేక్ ఆఫ్ సమ్ పిక్చర్స్, some videos, this is not good. And one side
chudandi meer anna dantlani conservation anna dantlo enta apohalu unnayi. Moon nella kindata adigi pandulni champadaniki panchayati vallaki permission avunu
no
are agi adigi pandulu em tintayi usually dumpalu tintayi dumpalu tindaniki paru. అంటే అడవిలో దుంపలు ఈ రోజు దొరకడం లేదు, అందుకే బయటకు వస్తున్నాయన్నది అది క్లియర్ నిదర్శనం. అవును, సో కాంట్ ది ఫారెస్ట్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ క్రియేట్ సమ్ జోన్ ఆఫ్ దేర్ యూనో ఫుడ్ స్టఫ్ ఆర్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ యూనో అడాప్టేషన్ మెకానిజమ్స్. అవి అక్కడ ఎందుకు వస్తున్నాయి అని అంటే వాటికి అక్కడ తిండి దొరకలేదు కనుక వస్తున్నాయి. బీహార్ నుంచి హైదరాబాద్ అటు బిల్డింగ్ కట్టడానికి ఎందుకు వస్తున్నాయి అంటే అడవానికి నౌకరీ లేదు. ఈ రోజు ఏమైతున్నది, ఎలిఫెంట్స్ ఆర్ కమింగ్ టు చిత్తూర్ అండ్ సిటప్. ఓకే, వి డోంట్ నో, కానీ వై ఇట్ ఈస్ కమింగ్ టు చిత్తూర్ ఇస్ బికాస్ ఇట్ వాస్ స్కేర్డ్. ఇట్ లివ్స్ ఇన్ ఎ ఫ్యామిలీ లైఫ్. వై మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద టైగర్స్ అండ్ లెపర్స్ ఆర్ కమింగ్ అండ్ రోమింగ్ ఇన్ హైదరాబాద్ హైటెక్ సిటీ. వై శంషాబాద్కి వచ్చింది, అదేమన్నా ఎయిర్పోర్ట్లో ఎక్కడికన్నా పోదామా? Its resources, its habitation is being destroyed. So ivanni kuda aalochana chestunnada edi manam conserve cheyala em che conserve chesin daniki ippudu this particular logic aptly fits for geo triple one. Why we should conserve the catchments of wind reserves? Yes, we want to make every green into a concrete green. How do you ensure? Did anybody assess what will be the quantum of wastewater that will be generated once the entire catchment becomes a human habitation, a real estate business? How many crores you need to treat this water? Is there an efficient work culture in us? And what is that a natural system cleans the water in a natural? Are we doing any kind of academic exercises on this? It is not mere academic, it is applied sciences. We are applying the basics of sciences for implementation in the development. This is most important. And conservation policy is a must for GIB to save the twin reservoirs. Even after 100 years, 2020-2021, these reservoirs said, we are alive, we are serving the people, don't disturb us. Yes? Did anybody endorse in the government that, look, even after 100 years, these zero energy reservoirs are flat? We need to understand the conservation policy. I tell you, Dr. Shivaprasad, the most important thing in this country, how it is losing its track is, you see, in my childhood, we were taught in the schools the kiddy bank.
Yeah.
Okay, 5 paisa, 10 paisa. You know, the system. We had a commissioner for small savings. That is nothing but, you know, you are inculcating a habit of savings. What is conservation? You are saving for a purpose. You should understand the purpose. We should educate people for that purpose. And today people talk, hey, we are getting Godavari waters, why for this? You may be interested in Godavari, I want my concrete waters. So, very important thing is, how do we inculcate a sense of conservation, a sense of savings? Today you say, sky is the limit, kuch bhi kharch kar lo, mere kuch SBI credit card hai, bas.
Another thing, Pharma City you have seen from Mucharla, Shadnagar to Ibrahimpatnam. Such a green zone, ecologically sensitive areas, forest cover is there. They announce a farming policy, they want to take away those lands. And here they are trying to, another MP from the ruling fraternity on the eve of birthday of a minister, that is a close family who are trying to rule Telangana, who are ruling Telangana. Now he says, Koti Mokkal Archana. One side they are cleaning ecology, including reserve forest area in Ibrahimpatnam. And another side, they are saying plant trees. They have already cleaned Chevella, this side area. How do you look at this scenario?
You see, it is, unfortunately, we are ruled by strict characters. Okay? Who are also suffering from bipolar disorders. When somebody says, you know, green archana vagaira lo, archana bagane unta. Kani manam bette mokka asala adi adivi kale. Adivi anante coexistence of flora and fauna. What grows on the ground, you know, the grasses. What grows as a bush. What grows as a tree. And which bird sits, bush, tree, or a grass. It's an entire dynamics of the ecosystem. You cannot create, it's not possible, but anybody. And okay, did they gone into assessment of any medical plants or rare medical plant species there? No. They have not done any biological assessments. Why biological assessment? We need to even come out with soil assessment of those areas where you want to convert from greens to concrete. No, it cannot be possible. You know, the thing is, you rectify your Patancheru, Pashamailaram, and Isnapur. And Isnapur, which is a highly contaminated area, where the groundwater hundreds of feet is contaminated. I'm shocked to see the real estate fellow announces, come and occupy. How they are given? So we are becoming a thick-skinned people. Neither we can smell, nor we can taste.
Corona affected.
So our policy makers made us not to think of. Okay?
Yeah.
We are deaf and dumb and mentally retarded.
Yeah.
Then why we are not raising any question? Why there is no debate in the assembly? Why there is no debate by the opposition parties outside? Everybody wants. Because another thing I want, that is an earthquake prone zone. last week and Nallamalai and adjoining foothills of Nallamalai, no studies were carried out on tectonic activities. You should also look into it.
So
but,
on, yeah. on one side, you have seen the buffer zones in and around. Hyderabad is the best city in the entire world, having such reserve government lands and natural habitations like forests, everything. Now, they which come under HMDA, Hyderabad Metro Development Authority, and GHMC, Greater Hyderabad Municipal Corporation, they have selling the lands away, these buffer zones. Now, not just Hyderabad, they have gone, reached out to panchayats, normal Zilla Parishads, second or third grade towns also. How do you look at this scenario? One side, you are finishing off all the buffer zone lands, selling them away. Now, other side, you are saying Koti, Vruksha Archana.
See, Koti, Vruksha Archana, but one thing is, they cannot sell the properties as the trustees of the system. And the bureaucrats cannot support it because they are the custodians of the system. And the most important thing is, these public lands, they have a purpose of conservation, and we also look for the future use. So most of the common lands in the panchayat areas have been either sold by the government or else government employed. Today, you see, the most unfortunate thing is, on one hand they say we are giving land to the poor. Yes. And I still remember when I was doing a workshop, a program in Chittoor, my volunteers came and said people are adamant in that particular tanda, they do not want to go for watershed. I myself went and discussed. You know what the answer was? Sir, this is given to us as an assigned land. Okay? We raise some crop, usually groundnut. We get in 4 months or 5 months, we are happy with this. You ask us to raise the plants. The first harvest is after 6 years. Do you guarantee and assure us that within this 6 years period, government will take back our lands? I said no, in those days, 25 years back. But can I say now? That poor man has great wisdom and vision. He knows it is all uncertain. And today you are taking away all that land and auctioning it for grosser purposes. And again you say, you have taken the lands from the deprived sections of the society, sold it to the rich hand in glove. And again you are claiming this money will be used for the deprived society. I wonder where the journalism has gone. You have taken from the poor fellow, sold it everything, yeah, and now you say I am distributing this money for the poor.
Ridiculous.
What a joke this is, And no one says, no one talks on this. I tell you, this country, this state and the country will be reduce it like a Brazil where you can't even afford to park your car outside your house. People will threaten, the deprived people or the street boys will threaten, I will bash your windshield if you don't come and give $2. We are pushing people, majority of the people, utter poverty. This dirty political games must be stopped.
Dirty political games must be stopped. Hyderabad gani oorlalla unna chuttu bhoomulanni teeskoni pedavaladaku adi oka upadi laga meerane parirakshana vishayamlo varu akkada edo vesi pandistha unte danni teeskoni dabbulunna vallaku corporate laku ammukuntu aa vachina dabbuto malla sankshemam ani cheppadam hasyaspadama kada asala bhoomulani evaru teeskomantunnaru mimmalu అది పరిరక్షణకు పనికి వస్తుందా లేదా ఇంత కాలం నుంచి ఇప్పుడు ఎందుకు అమ్మాల్సి వస్తుంది మీరు
ఎవడు అడుగుతున్నాడు ఇప్పుడు దాని దాని బెనిఫిట్ పొందే వర్గం కూడా అడుగుతుంది You see, what's happening is, you know, we heard of Tsars in Russia, you know, the French Revolution. But, you know, country, it all started with roti kapda or makan, you know, conservation and all of that. And urban land ceiling, where they should say, one fellow should have only one house in the city. But today, we are creating Tsars of Russia here. Is it not? We have, and in the last page you find, India today has 120 billion years. Is it the 120 billion years, okay? And 100 crores poor people. Wealth is going to 10% and 5% of the society. It is a dangerous trend. We will be reduced like Latin American countries and some of the countries like Sudan. Soon you will see this. This is an unfortunate thing. The only thing is Indians are so patient and they so strongly brainwashed on the Karma Siddhanta, so they don't make it. Okay, that is, today I see the opposition parties, they believe more than you and me, Karma Siddhanta, and they have a lot of patience, I do not know. And then why they are struggling to come back to power, I don't know. And what reasons they want to fight, nobody knows. No basic issues, conservation issues. Today I don't think that the entire country, any opposition leader or opposition, anybody have organized a debate on conservation policy. No? What kind of this is unfortunate, Dr.
Very, very. Another last question. Last question. You have seen Andhra Pradesh removing mangroves to construct housing, which mangroves would have protected sea flooding, and as you rightly said, it would have interfered with the wind also. The same thing happened in Kerala, Cochin, that ocean, that name they gave, when they constructed huge buildings. Like in Mumbai also, Supreme Court came down heavily, they were all demolished. And you find such type of recent happenings in Kerala also. Entire rivers, they get flooded and everything comes out, all the dirt, including plastic, everything. The next moment, they are drying. How do you relate these scenarios?
You see, one thing is, you see, on the name of social development, we are making all kinds of nonsense. And the other rest of the society is not bringing out the issues which they are fooling the people. They feel that, you know, they may be branded, they may be black sheep. But in reality is, you see, the entire country is going into huge economic losses and the frequency of disasters increasing day by day. And today I was listening in the TV channel, one of the sitting parties spokesperson talking. It's usual government to take loans. Yes, it's easy. But using for a right purpose efficiently should be monitored. Nobody, objecting that. So if you are generating revenue, you are taking loans, and for what purpose you are using? Buying the super luxury cars of 30 lakhs, 40 lakhs for policy makers and giving them 50,000 rupees phone perks? Can anybody make 50,000 rupees bill in this WhatsApp calling? So important thing is, though we have all these postal zone regulation and all, they violated everything. And interestingly, after the Divisima cyclone 1977, we had a World Bank project of mangrove conservation all along the coast of 600 kilometers. And probably Kerala and Mumbai, very sensitive zone, what happens is, we are creating a path of our own mechanisms of perish. The cities which flourish will soon or later maybe soon what I am saying is in the not in the geological time scale, but in the human scale. Maybe we are facing this particular problem, and soon all these cities will, they may not perish under the floods, but they will definitely perish under the epidemics, because of the flood water is not going out of the cities, will spread more communicable diseases.
Yes.
That is the danger.
We have seen Periyar River, Cochin Airport is there. Likewise, in Hyderabad, you have seen lakes, how they have been encroached. Mumbai, Bengaluru, you name all the cities, northern side cities. Catchment areas are there, and full tank level, how can they be ignored and allowed construction? Concrete is in the name of development in such areas. If that is the case, how can you say there is a conservation policy? That's the last question, sir.
There is no conservation. There is only one policy, and probably the government will announce for a tender to get allow the land, because they want to, they do not want to disturb the encroachers and want to find a solution. I think it is only allow the land can help us. So, inshallah, hum log upar wale ke bas meherbani kijiye. Jitne din jeete hain, jeete hain baad. You know, nobody wants to make raise voice, nobody wants to question. The country, the Hindu Tattva is basically on logic, reasoning, questioning, you know, the entire Indian culture. And today we do not want to raise anything. We want to be very good boys like Ramu. Ramu will perish, we all perish. That is an unfortunate thing. We must have a conservation policy. We should educate and sensitize the entire student community and others, and we should have a different conservation policy for coastal areas, for areas like Telangana, where it is an upland area, and what kind of a conservation policy is needed. We should look into it. This is very important. It's not, you know, Government of India, you know, used to give very good guidelines, you know, the preamble and all common, but in the guidelines they always emphasize that the states have different geoclimatic conditions, so you need to make suitable changes for implementation. This the bureaucrats will never do it. Vallaki endante gampa gutta anni gampa guttala activities not. So the innovation is dead, questioning is dead. But yes, we must raise this voice. We ask for conservation. We have to inculcate the sense of conservation and savings in this country. That is most important. The people should ask, demand the government that revival of the small savings schemes, which is more useful for the middle class and below the middle.
Yep. Right.
We should ask them. Apart from asking for the conservation policy, we should ask.
Yep.
So thank you so much, Dr.
Shukla. I should thank you from the bottom of my heart. Being in such a situation, you have come to the live show, sensitizing people. At least now, people have to become citizens.
And this, when I saw, you know, when I was reading yesterday and today newspapers and all, and even the WhatsApp, today World Conservation Day, you know, a hand with a plant. That means conservation is only planting? Conservation, is it not for water? Is it not for springs? Is it not for the human beings? You know, with pollution, the genetic mutation is happening. What kind of next generation will appear, we do not know. So we have to think very seriously on conservation.
Right.
And also on the adulteration, you know, stopping chemicalization of the agriculture systems.
Yes.
This is all part of conservation, conservation practices, conservation production. Conservation is not merely freezing something, you know, you put in the deep freezer and forget it.
Right.
No.
Right.
It's a dynamic system out there. So So thank you so much, sir. Thank
right,
you.
Right, right. Done, done, sir. So, at least conservation is not just one day's job. It should be a continuous process. And you should understand what you mean by conservation. Just holding a plant in your hand, posing for the photographs, trying to go for the sapling, this is not. There is a lot to do. The first thing is people have to become citizens, because we are the constitutional authority. We have submitted constitution to ourselves. For our better living, we should have a peaceful coexistence with the environment, with the nature. The nature consists of, as rightly said, not just only plants, air, water, so many things, human existence. And the beautiful lakes, the nature has bestowed us with lakes, rivers, oceans. Are we trying to protect them? That is where the conservation has to start. Give an example like Telangana. You are destroying, in the name of GO111, Usman Sagar, Gandipet we call, Himayat Sagar, and Manjira, the pure drinking water lakes. And they were connected with so many small lakes, so that Hyderabad, after that flooding, infamous flooding when people lost lives, because of this chain of lakes, we were never having that flood scenario. But full tank level for my this thing, it will be around 12 kilometers radius. Are we allowing them to survive, the catchment areas and all these tanks, lakes? One side you are destroying them, and Ibrahimpatnam, you have seen the best example, forest area is there, and in and around Hyderabad, reserve forest areas, you are selling them away on one side, and another side you are trying to say we are planting 1 crore saplings. What an ambiguity. For the sake of few, to make them rich and to see that they are the custodians of people participatory democracy called elections, you are destroying the nature, destroying the livelihood of so many. Not only that, the ecological imbalances will result in, as rightly pointed out, the animals moving from the forest to habitations where people live, because you are destroying the natural resources. At least this should be borne in mind. Whether it is Kerala, you have seen Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Maharashtra, name the state, everywhere the catchments encroached, nature destroyed in the name of development, but at the cost of environment and nature, wherein we were having peaceful coexistence, resulting in all this. So you are trying to remove, as he rightly pointed out, Subbarao Garu, the avenues of the poor, selling them to the rich, and stating that the money from that rich is going to again mitigate the poor. What, where is the logic? You are destroying the nature to make someone rich, and you say you will give some welfare schemes so that they become parasites and they die, because till then you are nature friendly. Now when you become go against the nature, nature will have its own fury, and unfortunately the innocents are dying. At least now people will understand, they will become better citizens, question why this development, why are you selling away these lands, why lakes are being encroached, why rivers are shrinking, why in the name of development on the oceans this concrete jungle is being built, removing mangroves and every natural habitats. Only then you say we are conserving the world. That will be the best way to say World Nature Conservation Day. Otherwise you are following, and as he rightly pointed out, we don't know when we would perish because of the fury of the nature, which we have already seen, right from Uttarakhand to Kanyakumari, Kashmir to Kanyakumari. These happenings keep repeating until and unless we become sensitized, aware. The awareness is the critical aspect, and once you become aware, you should understand these natural resources belong to each and every citizen of this country, not to a few to become billionaires living a family of four in plush bungalows at the suffering of every segment of the society. Thank you, sir. Take care.
Thank you.
For all Indians, Sukha Nidra Shubha Ratri for the world over. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Bye.
Even sleeping is part of conservation of energy.
Wonderful. At least while you sleep, understand,
yeah,
even the nature also should sleep adequately.
Yeah.
Right. Right, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Right.